بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. نحمد الله ونشكره ونصلي ونسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أبدأ بسم الله مستعينا، راض به مدبرا معينا. All praise due to Allah, we praise Him and we thanks Him and we seek the help from Him. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide Him, and whomever misguide, no one will guide Him. I bear witness and I believe there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Almighty and Muhammad is the last and final messenger. Today inshallah, we continue the series of Sahaba, the life of Sahaba, the life of the light. Sahaba to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the companion of the Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah, whom they study in the best school with the best teacher, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's very, very, very difficult to choose a flower from a garden full of flower. And it's very, very difficult to select the best star among of millions of stars. Sahabatu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were like the stars. They were like the moon. They were like the light. They learn and they achieve and they seek the knowledge from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Today, we're going to talk about a person, amazing Sahabi, without any doubt. Sahabi, he was the superstar over all the stars. He was the most knowledgeable person among of the Sahaba. He was the highest in the knowledge when you come to talk about al-halal wal-haram. And that witness and that certificate and that award, from whom? From the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, أعلم الصحابة بالحلال والحرام معاذ بن جبل. That Sahabi, what his name? معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه. معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه. معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. This Sahabi, by the saying of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the hadith, وَأَعْلَمُ, and the most knowledgeable and the highest in knowledge when you come across to halal and haram is Mu'adhu ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. What an amazing award from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to that Sahabi, honored by this character, honored by this quality, the knowledge, the ilm. Al-ilm. Also, moreover, Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu, he was one of the best leader among of the Sahaba. The Nabi select him and Abu Musa al-Ash'ari to go and lead the Yemen, to be the president, to be the ruler, to be the teacher, to be the who can deliver Islam to that country. Radiyallahu anhu wa radha. What an amazing Sahabi, Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu. Mu'adh ibn Jabal, let's go inside, in depth, inside his life, inside his stories. The hadith, the one he mentioned, his value, his virtue. his events. Allahu Akbar. What his name? Mu'adh ibn Jabal, his name, Mu'adh ibn Jabal ibn Amr ibn Aws al-Ansari al-Khazraji al-Madani al-Badri Abu Abdurrahman. What an amazing name, what an amazing character. He is from the tribes Aws. And as you know, Al-Ansar, they were two tribes. They were two tribes, Al-Aws and Al-Khazraj. So he is from Aws. And also, he is from Khazraj, sorry. He was from the Al-Khazraj. Bin Aws is a grandfather name. Al-Ansari from the supporter. Al-Khazraji from Al-Khazraj. And both of the tribes, they were very good in Islam, and they embrace Islam, and they support the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they give the bay'ah, the pledge to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to give him full support and sacrifice until the last person exists. They give the command, they give the word, they give the pledge. We are willing to die for sake of Islam, to revive up the word of La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. Al-Madani from Medina, Al-Badri, that means he attend the battle of Badr. And as you know, any Sahabi attend battle of Badr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pleased from him. Radiallahu anhum arda. How he looked like? He was tall and handsome, beautiful person, good looking, tall person. Allahu Akbar, Mu'adh ibn Jabal. He attained the pledge of Al-Bay'ah, Al-Aqaba al-Thaniya. As you know, the group of people of Al-Ansar, they came to Medina the first time, they did the pledge, they came back to Medina, then the second time they come for Hajj, and they give the pledge for Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Mu'adh ibn Jabal, he was with them. He gave the pledge to Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam sent with them Mus'ab ibn Umair to be as a first ambassador. Ambassador, Safiran, okay, the first teacher, the first who can call to Islam with them, to teach them al-Islam. So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam selected Mus'ab ibn Umair, kana hafiz al-Quran, he was well known in the Quran, okay. Then he went with those group to Al-Madina, and Mu'adh ibn Jabal was very close to Mus'ab ibn Umair, and he used to give him ideas in da'wah. He said, oh, Mus'ab ibn Umair, go and give da'wah to Sa'd ibn Zurara, Sa'd ibn Mu'adh. They were the leaders of Al-Aws and Al-Khazraj. Those are big leaders. Go and give them call them to Islam. Then Mus'ab ibn Umair, he listened to Mu'adh ibn Jabal, and he used to go and tell them about Quran, about Allah, about Islam. And they become a Muslim. And when they become those group of people, become a Muslim, the people of Medina starting accepting Islam one by one. Until in Medina, every and each house, you will find a group of people become a Muslim. Before the migration of Rasulullah to Medina. So, Mu'adh ibn Jabal, radiallahu anhu, he was a da'iyah. He was a knowledgeable, and he was not from the Muhajirin. That is something make me shocked. Yani, most of the Sahaba, the famous one, they were from Muhajirin because they stayed long years with the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But Mu'adh ibn Jabal from Medina. And although he's from Medina, and with this short of period of time, he became the most knowledgeable Sahabi in Halal and Haram, and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam selected him to be a leader and a ruler to Yemen. Let's talk a little bit about his virtue and his value. First value and first virtue that Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, peace be upon him, he declared in clear hadith that Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he loved Mu'adh ibn Jabal. What an amazing value. يقول ابن معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه أخذ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوما بيدي فقال لي يا معاذ والله إني لأحبك. معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه, he narrated the hadith that one time النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم hold my hand, أخذ بيدي hold my hand and he said يا معاذ, أو معاذ, والله, by the name of Allah, indeed, surely, I love you. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that statement from whom? From the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From the best man who walked over this earth. He witnessed Mu'adh. Not the Mu'adh, he said that word. That Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to Mu'adh, Allahu Akbar. Then what he replied, he said, فَقُلْتُ بِأَبِي أَنْتَ وَأُمِّي وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي لَأُحِبُّكَ. And the word is بِأَبِي أَنْتَ وَأُمِّي, يعني يا رسول الله, you are higher value and virtue and love and passion than my father and my mother, and I will sacrifice everything for you, ya رسول الله. Indeed and surely, wallahi, I love you. What an amazing reply from Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu. Then he said, oh Mu'adh, indeed I would like to give you wasiyah. Wasiyah means an advice, okay, and an advice. لا تدعنا أن تقول دبر كل صلاة اللهم أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, I advise you and tell you something good for you, that you never leave, لا تدعنا, don't leave or stop doing and saying the dua after each salah, اللهم, oh Allah, help me, okay, على ذكرك, to remember you, وشكرك, to thanks you, وحسن عبادتك, عبادتك, to perform the best ibadah for you and do my ibadah in best way. That's what is mean وحسن عبادتك. Some benefit from this hadith that it's lawful to swear by the name of Allah to make your statement is surely and firmly. Also, another benefit from this hadith by saying wallahi inni la uhibbuka i'lam al mahbub bihubb, yani I tell who I love, the one I love him, I will tell him my love and my passion and my admire, okay, my closeness to you. That is also the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this is the wasiyah, the advice of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, إِذَا أَحَبَّ الرَّجُلُ أَخَاهُ فَلْيُخْبِرْهُ أَنَّهُ يُحِبُّهُ. If a person, he loves another person, so he should tell him. He should tell him. فَلْيُخْبِرْهُ, or that person should tell that the other person that I love him. And here we learn the sunnah. Many people, subhanAllah, they have the love and admire and closeness, but he shy to tell. Then the person, subhanAllah, the other party, he will unaware, and he might not care so much to that person, then he will broke. The love will be replaced to hate. Oh, I call him many times, I try to be close to him, but that person, he's okay, he's all right, but not so much reply because he doesn't know about your feeling. Then if a couple of times he did not show that, what do you call, response, all right, then what will happen? The other party will broke. And this is many relationship, it's become a weaker because of not following the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu. When I like a person, tell him, I love you for sake of Allah, I like your personality, I like to learn from you. So the person, he will be more, inshallah, understanding, and will become, the relationship will become more stronger and last longer. طيب وعن أنس رضي الله عنه أن رجلا كان عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فمر رجل به فقال يا رسول الله إني لأحب هذا. One time, the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he was sitting, and a person, he was talking to the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Another person, he passed by, and the person, he said, "Ya Rasulullah, the one he passed by, I love him for the sake of Allah." Then Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he asked him, "Did you tell him?" He said, "No." He said, "Go and tell him. Go and tell him." Then what he teach us? If somebody said, "I love you for the sake of Allah," then you have to respond, أحبك الذي أحببتني من أجله. May Allah love you because you love me for sake of him. May Allah love you for sake of him. And this is also between the sister is lawful. Since it's applicable to the man, also can be applicable to woman. So also she can say, يا أختي في الله, or my sister for sake of Allah, I love you for sake of Allah. And I wish, inshallah, we gather in Jannah under the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We help each other for إيمان and faith and عبادة and etc. طيب ويقول معاذ بن جبل أردت سفرا فقلت يا رسول الله أوصني. معاذ بن جبل one time he said, يا رسول الله, I'm planning to travel, so give me an advice. Then Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, he gave him a beautiful advices. He said, أعبد الله ولا تشرك به شيئا. Worship Allah and never associate anyone with him. وَعْمَلْ لِلَّهِ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ, and worship Allah as you are seeing him. وَأَعْدِدْ نَفْسَكَ فِي الْمَوْتَى, and think yourself as among of the dead people. That you always thinking about the death in order to give you awakening to prepare for the akhirah. This is when a person remember the death, he will become more active in ibadah, more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more sincere in the salah, more ikhlas in ibadat. So this is the purpose of thinking about the death. Not to feel just scared or fear, yes, it's a part of it, but also to give you a motivation to do better for akhirah. And وَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى عِنْدَ كُلِّ حَجَرٍ وَكُلِّ شَجَرٍ, and remember Allah in every a stone or rock and every tree. When you travel, wherever you pass by tree, stone, so always your mind, it's as a reminder to you to remember Allah. Subhanallah. Nowadays I see it in some countries, they put a signboard. Say Subhanallah, say Alhamdulillah, remember Allah. So it's just a reminder when you're traveling, your tongue still saying or remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وإذا عملت سيئة فعمل بجانبها حسنة السر بالسر, and if you fall in the shortcoming or sin or wrong, do good deeds, okay, to replace that bad deeds. If you did the wrong secretly, do the حسنة secretly, and if openly, do it openly. You get what the meaning of the hadith? That means you did wrong, secretly do the ibadah secretly, and think that Allah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replace my shortcoming, my wrong, my mistakes, my this, with this good deeds I'm doing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is very good solution for a person, he fall in the sin, to do the good deeds, so the good deeds will replace and wipe the sin and replace it with the good deeds. And another time, Mu'adh ibn Jabal, he said, "Ya Rasulullah, awsini, give me an advice." He said to him, "Ittaq Allah haythu ma kunt." Fear Allah and put the awareness of Allah wherever you go. Wherever you go. قال Mu'adh, "Zidni," and give me more. He said, "Atbi' as-sayyi'ata al-hasanata tamhuha." Follow the bad deeds with the good deeds will wipe the bad deeds. قال زدني, give me more. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم خالق الناس بخلق حسن. What is mean خالق الناس بخلق حسن? Mean, okay, deal with the people in the perfect manner. Deal with the people with the morality, with a good akhlaq, with behavior. Okay, this is a really amazing hadith, and we call this hadith min jawami' al-kalim. What is min jawami' al-kalim? Mean hadith, it has a short statement but cover so many topics. So many topics. First one, taqwa, awareness of Allah. Second one, doing the good deeds, the third one about the good akhlaq. And this is the main things in Islam. Tawheed and faith and fear and belief. Second one, doing good deeds. The third one, to be a behave and good akhlaq with the Muslims. As this advice, if every Muslim, wallahi, I can say, if every single Muslim or Muslimah implement this hadith, wallahi, the Muslims and Islam will change immediately around the world. They have the haqid, they have the fear, the awareness, they do the good deeds, and they have a good behavior. This is really what the Muslims need. And this is, we call, the bag of the traveler. The bag of traveler. The traveler need to fear Allah and aware, put the awareness of Allah. Because the traveling, you might go across many sin, or many mistakes, and many shortcomings. So that the fearness of Allah will help you to abandon and avoid. If somehow you fall in the mistake, replaced with a good deeds, and your akhlaq is like a perfume. Everybody will smell it, and everybody will talk about Islam in good word. When you travel to other country and show the good akhlaq of Islam, this mashallah, the Muslims, they are good people. They smile, they are good behavior, they are trust, they are not cheating, they are not lying, they are not aggressive, they are not cursing, they are not bad people. Then we deliver the good picture of Islam. Alright, so this is the hadith, is very good hadith. Another hadith, qala Mu'adh ibn Jabal, qala li an-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ala adulluka ala babin min abwab al-Jannah. Shall I guide you or tell you or share with you door or gate, one of the, that door or that gate, one of the, from the gates of Jannah. Shall I teach you a door of, one of the door of Al-Jannah? Then Mu'adh ibn Jabal said, وَمَا هُوَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, what is that? وَمَا هُوَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, قَالَ لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Say, لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. This is a dhikr, it's one of the door of Jannah. Yeah, subhanAllah, one of the door of lead you to enter Jannah. One of the ibadah can lead you to get the Jannah, to get the door of Jannah. Okay, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. And this one, it's inside this statement full of tawheed and awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, aqeedah. La hawl, there's no power. Wa la quwwata, la hawl, there's no ability, there's no power, there's no seeking any help except with the power and help and seek of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Showing, Ya Allah, I am nothing. I am out of my strength. I am out of my power. I am weak. I need you, Ya Allah. Give me your power. Give me your help. Give me strength. Okay? So this one, it's very amazing when you say it. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. And this is one of the treasure of Jannah. Another hadith, كنز من كنوز الجنة. كنز mean treasure. One of the treasure of Jannah, saying the dhikr of لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. Every time, wherever you can free, in your free time, when you're going, riding, wherever you say this, driving, say, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. وعن معاذ بن جبل, another hadith, لما بعثه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى اليمن, خرج معه رسول الله يوصيه. When معاذ بن جبل, he's going to Yemen. As a leader, okay, he's going to Yemen. Then Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he come out with him. All this ahadith showing how much Rasul loved Mu'adh. When he said, Awsini, give me an advice, there is a relationship, there is a love, there is a very close personality between the personality of Mu'adh ibn Jabal and Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Subhanallah, as a teacher and student, subhanallah. He said, Ya Rasul, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he come out with the Mu'adh, give him an advice. وَمُعَاذُ رَاكِبُ وَرَسُولَ اللَّهِ تَحْتَ رِجْلَيْهِ وَرَسُولَ اللَّهِ يَمْشِي تَحْتَ رِجْلَيْهِ. يعني, what an amazing picture. Mu'adh ibn Jabal riding the horse and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam walking and holding the horse. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, as Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam willing to show the Mu'ad bin Jabal humbleness, the love and the closeness to Mu'ad bin Jabal. Don't worry, you remain in the horse. Let's walk together. Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When he finished, he said, Ya Mu'ad, innaka asa alla talqani ba'd aami hadha. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. Here is an emotional event. Very touching. He said, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you might not see me after this year. Yani as a farewell. This is final farewell between me and you. And you might pass by from my masjid or from my grave. Then Mu'adh ibn Jabal. Mu'adh ibn Jabal get emotional. Wabaka. And he cried. And he said, ثم التفت أي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بوجهه نحو المدينة فقال إن أولى الناس بي المتقون من كانوا وحيث كانوا. Then النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم to minimize the feeling of Mu'adh, he said, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said to the Medina, the most people is belong to me and I am belong to them. They will be part of me. Those they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from wherever they are. Wherever they are. Yani don't worry, Mu'adh ibn Jabal. Even you going to Yemen, you'll be far away, you might not see me, you still you'll be part of me. You still be, inshallah, part of me. That what is the other meaning, what the translation of the hadith, he said, the most people is belong to me, the one they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever they are. As you, Mu'adh, you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you also we will be part of me, radiyallahu anhu. And this is all a hadith I mentioned to you showing how much Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loved Mu'adh ibn Jabal, and it was an amazing virtue for Mu'adh ibn Jabal. First point is love. Second point, Mu'adh ibn Jabal, he was very care. He was very, thinking and steadfast that he will be among the people of Jannah and he will be away and abandon himself from the people of Jahannam. What is the dalil? What's the evidence? One time Mu'adh ibn Jabal, he said, Ya Rasulallah, أخبرني بعمل يدخلني الجنة ويباعدني عن النار. This hadith is one of the very famous hadith. Even Imam al-Nawawi, he wrote it and he selected among of the 40 hadith. Imam al-Nawawi, he tried to select the best and the most important 40 hadith among of all the hadith, and he wrote his book, Al-Arba'in al-Nawawiyya, the 40 hadith. And one of them, this hadith, hadith ibn Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu, when he asked, Oh Rasulullah, tell me a amal, tell me a deeds, an action, an ibadah, whatever, that will take me to Jannah and abandon me from the Jahannam. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, laqad sa'alta an azim. Indeed, you ask great question. Wa innahu layasirun ala man yassarahu Allahu alayhi. And that answer will be very easy to whomever Allah made it easy to them, or made it easy for them. And it's easy action, easy to do, and that easy if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy for the person. First, تعبد الله ولا تشرك به شيئا. To worship Allah and never associate anyone, any partner with Him. وتقيم الصلاة and perform صلاة. And establish the salah and do it in the right time, in the right way, give the right for the salah. That is all under the word of tuqim as-salah. Wa tu'ti zakah mean giving zakat. Wa tasum Ramadan, and you fast Ramadan. Wa tahujj al-bayt, and you perform hajj. Thumma qal, ala adulluka ala abwab al-khayr. Shall I teach you the gates and the doors of goodness? Abwab al-khayr. Al-khayr mean goodness, the good. Wa abwab mean doors, the gate. The window of the all goodness, the way of all goodness, the doors of all goodness, the gate of all goodness. قال الصوم جنة. Fasting, it's جنة. What is mean the word of جنة, جنة in English? جنة mean وقاية, mean safety. Safety. الصوم جنة. Fasting is a safety for the person. والصدقة تطفئ الخطيئة كما يطفئ الماء النار. And صدقة donation, okay, you give in the path of Allah, will off the sin as the fire will distinguish the water will distinguish the fire. As the water will off the fire, make it off, okay, no more exist, okay. So this is also the Sadaqa, the donation, will off the sin, or delete the sin, or take remove it away. وَصَلَاتُ الرَّجُلِ فِي جَوْفِ اللَّيْلِ أَوْ مِنْ جَوْفِ اللَّيْلِ And the performing the salah in the middle of night, that's مِنْ قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ ثُمَّ اقْتَلَ Then the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam recite a verse from Surah Al-Sajdah, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise the people of Jannah. One of their character, تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يعني their side will abandon the bed in the night. Referring to what? To do the قيام الليل. يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ They making dua to Allah. خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا They fear of Allah, full of fear of Allah and full of hope. And seek the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ And from whatever we give them, they will give sadaqa donation. Then he continued the second verse. فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ فَلَا تَعْلَمُوا No self or soul or a person know how much Allah prepared for them the reward as an honor for them in whatever they do. In whatever they did from hasanat and good deeds. Those type of people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for them amazing and great reward in the Akhirah, in Jannah, and no one know how much Allah prepared for them that the word and award and the reward. Allahu Akbar. ثم قال ألا أخبرك برأس الأمر وعاموده وذروة سنامه Shall I teach you the head of الأمر, the things, the head of the things in Islam وعاموده and the column of Islam وَذُرْوَةُ سَنَامِهِ The most important things in Islam that shall I tell you this? He said رَأْسُ الْأَمْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ The head of everything, the head of the faith, the head of the faith is the Islam. وَعَامُودُهُ The column of the Islam or the column of the religion is الصَّلَاةِ Performing Salah. وَذُرْوَةُ سَنَامِهِ الْجِهَادِ Okay, also very important things in Islam is الجهاد fighting in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثم قال ألا أخبرك بملاك ذلك كله Shall I tell you things is the most important over all what I told you? قال بلى يا رسول الله Yes, tell me what that very important. قال فأخذ بلسانه He took his tongue and وقال كف عليك هذا Avoid that. Control that. Be aware from your tongue. Allahu Akbar. قلت يا رسول الله وإنا لمؤاخذون بما نتكلم به Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to judge us about what we are saying? معاذ بن جبل asking question to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال ثكلتك أمك Allahu Akbar. That's saying يعني wish that your mother not deliver to you. What's this question you ask? Sometimes we make communication. What this is question? Oh, shall your mother not bring you this dunya? That's, you should know about, aware about the tongue. And Mu'adh bin Jabal asking very question like, asking Ya Rasul, Ya Rasulullah, are we being judged because of our tongue? Whatever we say going to be judged? Of course. Subhanallah. وَهَلْ يُكَبُّ The Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, وَهَلْ يُكَبُّ النَّاسَ فِي النَّارِ عَلَى وُجُوهِهِمْ إِلَّا حَصَائِدَ أَلْسِنَتِهِمْ The people will be throwing in Jahannam, in hellfire, over their face because of their tongue. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save our tongue. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our tongue always in remembering of Allah, always speaking good, always inviting the people to al-amru bil-ma'roof wal-nahi anil-munkar, to the goodness. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save our tongue, and may Allah control our tongue to speak good or keep silent. And this is wallahi the most difficult things. Sometimes I feel it is more difficult than the performing ibadah or salah or dua. This is the easy part. Doing salah, you do wudu, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, easy. But control your tongue, oh, is the hardest things for the human being, to control his tongue from backbiting, from talking haram, from lying, or saying something foolish. And subhanallah, that's a tongue is always lead the person to all situation. Wallahi, the most things has the right to put it in the jail, that's your tongue. Put your tongue in jail and locked, and make sure speak only good and okay, say good, or otherwise lock it. Subhanallah. And this is amazing advice to Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu. Wallahi, this hadith, seriously, we need a couple of lectures only to give tafsir to this hadith by details, by examples. Subhanallah. We are just beginning about the story of Mu'adh ibn Jabal. Two points we learned today about how much Nabi Sallam loved him and close to him. And number two, how much Mu'adh ibn Jabal, he is aware and care that he want to be among of the people of Jannah, and he want to be a band and away from the people of Jahannam. So by asking Rasulullah ﷺ this hadith. So from this hadith, Islam is very important. All the pillars of Islam. Also we learn from this hadith, controlling our tongue. And we have to understand also the Islam, how important is the Islam, how important is the Salah, and how important al-Jihad in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for the woman, her Jihad is what? Hajj, performing Hajj. That's her Jihad. Okay, her Jihad, okay, performing Hajj. Okay, also we learned today the strong relationship between Mu'adh ibn Jabal and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that he gave him so many advices and nasiha, and also Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam swear by the name of Allah that I love Mu'adh ibn Jabal. Also we learn about one of his great virtue, that Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam select him to go to lead the Yemen, to be a master of Yemen, to be a leader of Yemen, to be a teacher of Yemen, to be a deliver the message to the people of Yemen like a messenger. Showing that Mu'adh ibn Jabal, he has amazing and great character and personality to take this high and very important task. And Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, he was capable to carry this task, and showing that Mu'adh ibn Jabal, when the Nabi ﷺ mentioned to him, I might not see you after this year, Allahu Akbar, Mu'adh ibn Jabal start crying, show how much he is a man. And I tell you something, in the culture of those people, you don't understand those Arabian. Those Arabian, in their culture, a man, if drop of tear come out, this is dishonorship for the male. You cannot take out the tear from them. The son or daughter might die and he's okay, he control. He will never utter a word. As a man, woman, they do whatever, it's okay for them. Okay, in that culture, before Islam, a man is a warrior. He is responsible for everything. He is a strong, he is a muqatil, he is mujahid, he is holding the sword. But look at, after Islam, those people, full of feeling, full of passion. They cry like a child when he hear Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he might farewell him. Allahu Akbar. It's not easy. We talk, easy talk. But when we come to review and imagine, those men, strong, tall, warrior, big man, subhanallah, crying like a child in front of the hand of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. وسلم because of the one word he said, Nabi Sallam, I might not see you after this year. We have to feel the story of Sahaba. That's why our lecture is live of Sahaba. We don't want to deliver, there's plenty of lectures in the book, but we want to imagine the situation, the feeling, the learning method from the life of Sahaba radiallahu anhu. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us and make us understand and make us implement what we are reading. So from now on, inshallah, we learn a lesson. If I love sister, my sister in Islam, show little passion, show little love, show little saying, talking, visiting, caring. Okay, if she's sick, I care about her, I visit her, I try to remind her, inshallah, we might see each other in Jannah. We will be, inshallah, bi'idhnillah, together in Jannah. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over you, this whatever happened to you, it's a rewarded and will be wiped your sin. This is how the relationship showing, we call as-sadiq waqt ad-diq, the friend in the time of hardship. Not the first, when the person he is a hardship, all the friend run away. Ya Allah, where are you? I thought you are the best friend of mine. SubhanAllah, and I've been cross about this, so many people, I thought they are the best to me. Then I'm small problem, I need their help, they are the first people run away. And another friend, I couldn't believe he will help. MashaAllah, he show all the help. So that in the time of hardship, you know who is the real person, who is the fake one. When you put the gold with the fire, you know that is really pure gold or mixture. So this is subhanAllah how Sahaba, when they are in the hardship, they showed to Rasulullah the love and passion and sacrifice and everything. They were the true believer. جزاكم الله خير. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept us. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا وتقبل منا وارحمنا وعاملنا بالإحسان إحسانا وسيئات عفوا وغفرانا يا رب العالمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. إن شاء الله next class we continue معاذ بن جبل part 2, and we might show you some video about where his grave, where his masajid of Mu'adh bin Jabal. He has a plenty of places, masajid, reminder to us some of the great events for Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu. Jazakumullah khair.